probably no different to you guys watching this in that I watch loads of carp fishing films on YouTube. And it's fair to say we tend to see a lot of the same venues over and over again with different people. But today, I'm at a venue that I can guarantee you there's never ever been a vlog done on here. And it's right out in the middle of nowhere. It's so quiet, you can't even hear a road. It's absolutely beautiful. There's the odd aeroplane every now and again, but it's a lovely, right remote venue, and it's also got some nice carp in here as well. I won't tell you the exact location. All I'll tell you is it's called H Lake. It's a syndicate water right up north in Yorkshire, and it's got some beautiful carp in it. The biggest in here is about 37 pounds, but it's an absolutely stunning mid 30, upper 30, fully scaled as well. So there's some really nice carp to go at. Now I've had a walk round, which is quite difficult because there's loads of overgrown areas on this lake and some nice looking spots. I've had a look at a couple of areas which have taken me fancy, a little bit of chocolate water out in front of them, but I've made a decision of where I'm going to fish. So what I'm going to do now is just get the gear and then we'll walk back to the swim and I'll talk you through what's going on in front of it. You might be able to tell from the light levels at the moment that a few hours have passed since I did that little bit of a introduction, because we've been interrupted a few times by the rain and the weather. It's really dark and grey at the moment. There's a little bit of drizzle in the air as well, but I'm in the swim, and the great thing about this lake, as I said before, it's not a known venue and it's my first trip down here, and I don't think any of the swims have got names. I've certainly got not got numbers, and I don't know where I am. I'll just say it's on a point area. And the reason I've chosen this swim is because I've got an island straight in front. I've got loads of weed beds out to the right there. I've got channels going down to my left, straight out in front, and also around to the right. It's basically a feature-packed swim. It probably gets a little bit of attention on this lake because there's so many features here. But whenever I fish a walk for the first time, I always like to be able to spread my rods about to try and find where the carp are. And this is the perfect place to do that because there's just so many options available to me. I can only use three rods, but it's probably the kind of swim that you could do with about twice as many as that, even probably nine rods, and you'd probably just about fill all the gaps. But we're all set. And as you can see at the moment, the water is down a little bit. Some of these jetties are at least a couple of feet. You can see from the legs on the jetties that the water's probably about a couple of feet down. But I've still got some good depth in front of me. I've got an area out to the left here that goes down to about 8.5 foot. But the average is about 5-6 foot, something like that. Amongst the weed, it's a little bit shallower. But the three rods that I've got out, I've got one covering the far margin over there. It looks a perfect place where the carp are going to be patrolling up and down that margin. There aren't any swim. I can actually see a barn owl now just going along the hedge over there. You won't be able to catch it on the camera, but that's the beauty of this place. But that margin over there just screams a patrol route for carp. It just goes from one end of the lake up to the top in front of me there, down to the left there, and there's no swims down there at all. And obviously where there's no swims, there's definitely going to be carp. And the shelf itself, it does gradually drop off over there, and I've got a rod in about 3.5-4 foot of water, which is about ideal for this time of the year. We are late October, but today it's been actually quite warm. There's a little bit of rain about now, but and the temperature has dropped a little bit, but consistently it's probably been about 17, 18 degrees today. And tonight it's going to go down to about 10 degrees. So pretty good conditions for this time of the year. Middle rod, I've got that more in open water amongst the weed. It's gone down with a nice drop. There's an area just over the back of the first weed bed where it goes to about 5.5 foot. And when the rod's gone down, it's gone down lovely, nice drop, nice clean area. And the right-hand rod, that's pretty much the same as the middle rod in that it's amongst the weed, but it is round to the right there, just off those reeds in between the island and the weed beds. All three rods I'm absolutely confident with. I haven't seen any carp yet in the swim. It is a time of year when you do tend to get carp quite localised in areas. I don't know whether this area's been doing any bites recently. Roger, who owns the lake, has told me that there's not been many people down, and at the moment there's nobody down here. It's a 28-man syndicate, so they come and go as they please, but it definitely looks good for it. It's a lovely time of the year to be on the bank, and it's definitely a lovely lake to be at as well. This place is so quiet, every sound is magnified. You can hear that tractor probably just in the distance, but it's a few fields away from us and it sounds like it's right next to us. It's the same with the plains. It's so nice, this venue, it really is. And at the moment, nothing's happened on the rods. I've not caught anything other than a couple of bream last night. But if I'm honest, I'm just loving being here. It's just really nice venue to fish. I'm used to fishing lakes this year that are quite busy with anglers. There's only one other guy down here at the moment. And roads next to the lakes, planes going over all the time that are taking off from Heathrow or wherever, but here it's just completely different. And the other thing I like about it is it reminds me a little bit of Ashmead. I did a film on Ashmead earlier in the year, I think it was about April time, and that is one seriously special carp lake. It's a legendary carp lake among serious carp anglers. It's where you go to not just catch some nice fish, but to just enjoy being on a venue. And this is a little bit like that, because it's quiet, like I say, but you've got all these little channels. We're just one side of the lake at the moment, and this is a big opening of the lake, but you've got a channel that runs around there to the right. You've got this arm that runs around here. That runs up to where we're fishing, and then it goes around the back of another island there, and you've got all these little channels where the carp can escape, and it makes it really, really interesting. It's tricky fishing. It's that time of the year, October time, when it does get a little bit difficult, but I like it like that. You know, you tend to see a lot of these carp films, I said this at the beginning of the film, filmed on the same venues where you're almost guaranteed of getting fish action. And yes, of course, fishing is about catching fish. I love catching fish. I don't really care what size they are, either whether they're small fish, big fish. I just like being out here. But here, it's definitely not just about catching carp. It's a little bit of a challenging venue. I think there's about 110 fish in here over about 5 acres of water. But there's so many areas that they can hide away and escape. There's a few back channels around the back there where it doesn't look like anybody's been fishing for several weeks, and as I say, it's just lovely. You can hear the pheasants in the background now. We've seen barn owls, we've seen all sorts of wildlife, and I'm just loving being here. It's taking me away from the commercial side of carp fishing. It's taking me into the area of carp fishing that I really like. It's the roots of my carp fishing, which is where it all started for me, which is just about being on the bank, having that hunter instinct of trying to catch fish from a venue that I don't know anything about. And if the rods do go, I know it's going to be definitely interesting. So I'm just briefly going to run you through the rig that I'm using today, and as always, it's pretty simple and very much like the rigs that I use wherever I go. And what we've got is one of the Avid lead clips. I've got a nice little light lead on there, only 2 ounces today. I'm not fishing too far out. And then we've got roughly about 8 inches of captive coated hooklink. That's £15. And as always, I've taken all the outer coating off there, so we're left with this nice supple braid. That's knotless knotted to a size 6 snag hook. We've got a little liner on there. We've got a bait that's nice and tight to the shank of the hook. And today I'm using one of the bug wafters. That's one of the half-tone wafters. And there's nothing technical in the fishing that I'm doing at the moment. It's just about fishing for one bite at a time. So I'm just fishing that alongside half a dozen or so free offerings. And I know full well that if there's fish in the area and they're gonna be feeding, this has definitely got a chance of catching me a carp or two. It's definitely a different morning today than it was yesterday, and it feels pretty carpy at the moment because there's a nice breeze blowing straight into me. The air pressure's dropped. It's going to go below 1,000, which I think is pretty good carp fishing conditions, and nothing has still happened on the rods from a carp fishing point of view. I've had another bream last night, but we've got a few hours left now before the cameraman leaves, and can we pull out the bag? You know, that's the problem with fishing lakes like this. I don't know anything about it. I've said this numerous times during the film. And you are under a little bit of pressure to try and catch a fish from a venue like this because, you know, it's only 100 carp in 5 acres, loads of little channels and little areas for them to escape. And from what I can gather from talking to a few of the lads as well, is that this swim does get fish quite a lot. So are they wary of this area? I don't know, but I think it's more to do with the fact that at this time of the year, when you get towards early November, which is where we're not too far away, the fishing can get very patchy on lakes like this. So it's all about putting in a few extra days, a bit of extra time. And when Adam leaves in a short while, I'm probably going to stay on for another couple of days to give us a chance of trying to get a carp or two out of here, because I do feel as though something's going to happen. I really do. It's nice and windy now. It's a little bit cooler. And it's a pretty good job that I've got this bivvy up at the moment as well, which is the one man HQ, because it gives me that extra bit of protection, because the rain's going to come in this afternoon, and a bit of rain, a bit of low pressure. We all know that that's good carp fishing conditions, so let's hope we finish before Adam goes with a carp. But either way, I've still got probably another couple of days to try and pull this out of the bag if I can. Whenever I go to a new lake, all I ever want to do is catch a fish from it. But every now and again, you get lucky with a special one. And from talking to Bartlett the other day about this lake, there's not many original carp in this lake. I I think he said there's a handful or so, and they're all of varying different sizes. So to come here and get lucky by catching an original, I'm obviously proper chuffed. Now this fish, we know the biggest in here is 37 pounds. This fish has got to be 34 pounds smaller than the biggest fish in the lake. It's an absolute teeny one. I could probably hold it up with one hand, and it's probably better off on the Preston channel than it is the Avid channel, but it's a carp. And obviously that's what I came here for, to catch a fish, and I've got this nice one. Now, Adam the cameraman's about to leave in a moment, but we've got this fish on film. Now I'm gonna stay for another couple of days and see if I can get a better one. The conditions are definitely better. It's definitely more carpy now. So if in a moment you see me with some raw footage with some bigger fish, you know I've got lucky. But either way, at least I've caught one from another venue. And this venue, you definitely don't just come here to catch carp. You come here to enjoy yourself, because it's such a nice place. There you go. I know it's a bit of a cliche when they say it's not always about size, but we all like a big one. But I must say, even though this carp is really small, of course I'm very happy to have caught it. And I'm definitely happy to fish such a wonderful water as this, because honestly, it really isn't just about size for me today. So let this one go, and hopefully we can get ourselves a bigger one in the next couple of days. But either way, at least I've not blanked. There you go. Right, 48 hours on from that last bit of filming, and unfortunately I didn't catch anything else, but I've really enjoyed being on this lake. It's an absolutely beautiful place, and I know there's loads of carp lakes like this up and down the country, and it proves to me that carp fishing isn't just about catching fish, because I've sat there for 4 days in a wonderful environment. And I hope you've enjoyed watching, and all I've got to do now is get myself in the car back home and get my gear packed, so I'm on another adventure in 3 days' time when I'm off to Germany. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, and subscribe to the YouTube channel, and hopefully I'll be seeing you real soon.